Welcome, dear children. Children, please be ready with your English textbook and a pencil. I repeat, please be ready with your English textbook and a pencil. In our previous class, I have explained about the comprehension questions given in page 10, that is ABET. In our previous class, I have explained about the comprehension questions given in page 10. Now, let us do the next bit, that is BBIT. Look into BBIT, children. I guess you all have opened page 10. Read the names of the vehicles given below. Tick the names of the vehicles you have traveled by. Underline the names of the vehicles that you have seen in reality. I repeat, read the names of the vehicles given below. Tick the names of the vehicles you have traveled by. Underline the names of the vehicles that you have seen in reality. Means you have to tick, put a tick mark against the word about the name. Tick the names of the vehicles that you have traveled by. And you should underline the name of the vehicle if you have seen in reality. Now let us see the list of vehicles. Our first vehicle is auto rickshaw. This is a vehicle which is used to travel short distances. Even most of the children go to school by auto rickshaw. So you can underline and also tick. Our next vehicle is motorcycle. It is a two-wheeler which is mostly used for family purpose. So you can underline and tick. Our next vehicle is helicopter. It is used to travel in the air. Mostly VIPs travel by this. So I think you all have seen an helicopter but didn't travel by helicopter. So you can only underline. Next vehicle is bullock cart. It is mostly seen in villages. If you have traveled by a bullock cart, you can tick it. Tick and underline. If you have traveled by bullock cart, tick it. Only if you have seen it, underline. Going to the next set of vehicles. First one is aeroplane. It is used to go to far off places like other states and countries. It is used to travel longer distances in short time. So if you have traveled by aeroplane, you can tick it, children. And whoever has seen aeroplane, you can underline. Our next vehicle is bicycle. All the children love to ride a bicycle, which is pollution free. All class 3 children know to ride bicycle, I guess. So if you can ride, you can tick. And if you have seen it, I know everybody has seen a bicycle. So you can underline. Our next vehicle is lorry. It is a heavy vehicle used for transporting goods. Only underline, children. Next one is train. It runs on rails and carries many people at a time to different places. If you have traveled by a train, you can put a tick mark against the word and also underline. Going to the next set of vehicles. First one is car. Nowadays, car is commonly used vehicle. So put a tick mark and also underline. Next one is truck. Truck is used to transport goods. So only underline, children. Next one is ship. It is used to travel on water. If anyone of you have traveled by the ship, you can tick. And others, you can underline. Our next vehicle is Jeep. This is also commonly used vehicle. You can tick and also underline. Our next set of words is, first one is boat. It is mostly used for fishing. And if any one of you have traveled by a boat, you can tick against the word. Others, please underline. Next one is bus. It runs on road and most of us have traveled by it. So you can put a tick mark and also underline. Our next vehicle is van, which goes on the road. This is also commonly used vehicle. So put a tick mark and underline it. Now I request all the children to look into page 15. Please look into page 15. Children, please open page 15. Be reading. The title is Be Safe. First, let us read, children, then later I will explain. One day, Raju was late to station. One day, Raju was late to station. He tried to board the running train. He tried to board a running train. But he missed it and fell on the platform. But he missed it and fell on the platform. He broke his leg and was taken to a hospital. Rules are for our safety. Follow the rules to be safe. Yes, children. In the first picture, you can see a man running. His name is Raju. And he is trying to board the running train. Here, board means to get in. I repeat, board means to get in. So Raju is trying to get inside the running train. In the second picture, you can see Raju on the platform. What happened to Raju, children? Yes, he tried to get inside the moving train. He missed it and he fell on the platform. In the third picture, you can see Raju in the hospital with a broken leg. So children, we should never try to get inside a running train. It is very dangerous. Not only in the railway station, but we should follow safety rules at other places also. So let us learn a few safety rules to be followed at different places. Safety rules to be followed on road. First one, do not run on road. Yes, children, you should never run on the road because you may be hit by the passing vehicles. Second one, cross the road only at zebra crossing. Look at the picture, children. You can see a few children crossing the road at zebra crossing, which is very safe. Next one, ride your bicycle where traffic is very less. Yes, do not ride your bicycle on a busy road. It is very dangerous. Next one is, do not throw banana peels on the road. If you do so, what will happen, children? Others may slip and fall down and get injured. Our next one is, follow the traffic signals. These traffic signals, you can see them on the road displayed. So you should follow them. Now, let us look into the safety rules to be followed at home. Safety rules at home are very important to be safe. First one is, do not open the door to the strangers. I know your parents will never leave you all alone, but if this situation occurs, never open the door to the stranger. Stranger means a person whom we do not know. Second one is, do not operate electric gadgets on your own. If your hands are wet, you will get electric shock. Yes, if you touch electric gadgets with wet hands or if the wiring is not good, you may get shock. So be away from them, children. The next one is, do not play with matchsticks. Children, please don't play with matchsticks or fire. You may get burnt. Next one, do not spill water or oil on the floor. Yes, if you drop water or oil on the floor, you or any of your family members may slip and get injured. Do not play with sharp objects. Never play with sharp objects, children, like scissors, knife, because you may cut yourself. Now let us quickly jump into the safety rules to be followed at school. Very, very important, children. First one is, do not run in the corridors. Yes, do not run in the corridors, children. I know you all are very energetic and want to enjoy the pleasure of running, but corridors is not the right place to run. You can make use of playground. Next one, never jump on benches. Yes, children, you should never jump on benches. If you jump accidentally, you may fall down and you get hurt and you suffer so much pain. Not only you, and also you are troubling your parents. Next one is, do not fight with anyone. Yes, children, do not fight with anyone. If anyone troubles you, please inform your teacher. Next one. Next safety rule, do not run on stairs. Yes, children, while climbing the stairs or going down the stairs, you should never run. You may slip and fall and get injured. Next safety rule is, keep your classroom and surroundings clean. Always keep your classroom clean. Use dustbin to discard the waste. Parents, please make a note. English classwork, that is notes, details will be sent on My Class Campus app. Please follow and help your child to complete it. Parents, please make a note. English classwork, that is notes, details, will be sent on My Class Campus app. Please follow and help your child to complete it. That's all for today, children. Follow the safety rules at home and be safe. Thank you.